to one and all present here. We have amidst us the famous Sufi singer, Miss Harshdeep Kaur. We would like to welcome you, ma'am, with a music performance by some of our friends on a medley of songs sung by you.
Good time.
for that melodious performance. It is just the right start to today's program. We are all gathered here this morning to welcome the very well-known Indian playback singer, Ms. Harshdeep Kaur, to the Leadership Lecture Series at Global Indian International School. Winner of the title in two reality shows, Ms. Kaur has established herself as a successful Bollywood singer in Indian cinema, having recorded for films in various languages. She has even worked with some of the leading music directors, including A.R. Rahman, Pritam Chakraborty, Vishal Shekhar, Saleem Suleiman, Shankar Ehsaan Loy, Amit Trivedi, and Sohail Sen. Be it Heer, Ik Onkar, Kabira, or Zalima, Harshdeep Kaur's songs have always been a super hit. A very warm welcome, ma'am, to our campus. It is indeed an honor. Let us hear a loud round of applause for Ms. Harshdeep Kaur. We also welcome members of management, students, and teachers on this occasion.
Today's session is being telecast live, and we have thousands of parents watching us from the comfort of their homes and offices. Leadership is about making others better as a result of your presence and making sure that impact lasts in your absence. And all of us seated here are waiting to listen to our guest today for an everlasting impact on our lives. May I now request our guest, Ms. Harshdeep Kaur, to kindly come on stage and address the gathering on what it is to be a leader. Ma'am, please.
Indeed, a really good morning. Thank you, everybody. Can we please have a huge round of applause for all of you? Thank you so much. I've been welcomed in a lot of places before, but I can say this is the best welcome ever. So thank you to the students of Global Indian International School. And I must say, you all are so talented and so beautiful, inside out. I can't stop clapping for you, yeah? Come on! And that musical performance was brilliant. I loved listening to you guys, and you're so talented. I didn't know that Singapore is full of so much talent. Thank you for bringing me here, Shweta. And I don't know what to say, because I still feel I should be learning from you all, because you guys are so vibrant and so happy and so cheerful, and this is what we forget to do these days. We all need to smile a lot, right? You can talk with me, come on. So that's what we need to do. Ultimately, life is about being happy. So you should do whatever makes you happy. So I sing because music and singing, it gives me a lot of happiness. And the girls who were dancing when I arrived, even dancing gives me a lot of happiness. So basically, this is a small gist of life, that you should always do whatever makes you happy, and in whichever way you can contribute to the society. If you can spread happiness, you should do that. So if your singing is spreading happiness, you should sing. If it's not giving happiness, don't sing. Do something else. If your food, if you are good at cooking, you should cook and, you know, give it to others and make them smile. So it all comes around to this. I have many friends who are stuck in jobs, and they go to office and they're not very happy about it, and they'll be like, I get so tired in the office and I'm not enjoying my work. There's so much going on in the office and I'm so stressed. So anything that makes you, you know, feel like this and you regret doing it, you should not do it. So I consider myself really lucky that I am in a profession that I really enjoy. I love singing and it has become my profession. So I consider myself really blessed and really lucky. So even with you, studies are really very important to groom you and to learn about new things in life. You should listen to your parents, finish your studies, at least graduation. And early on, you should always, you know, look for what you are good at and what you enjoy doing the most. If you like to draw, if you like to paint, if you like to sing, if you like to dance, you should always think about it as a career option, because nowadays things are changing, people's mindsets are changing. Like earlier, how you know, people were like, "Hum apne bacche ko." You understand Hindi? So that's a big plus for all of you. Come on. You gotta make Hindi more global now. जैसे पहले कहते थे कि बच्चे को डॉक्टर बनाएंगे या इंजीनियर बनाएंगे या आर्किटेक्ट बनाएंगे, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि सिर्फ यही जॉब्स रहती हैं. यू कैन ऑलवेज गेट इनटू मोर क्रिएटिव जॉब्स, मोर क्रिएटिव थिंग्स. सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर सिंगर्स हियर? नो. व्हाट्स योर नेम? टेल मी व्हाट्स योर नेम. यू डोंट हैव अ नेम? And how did they take you in the school without a name? Come on.
Tell me your name. Sorry?
Okay, Mr. No Name. Says he doesn't like singing. What do you like doing? Okay, I think he's a very quiet person. You must be a good observer then. Okay, how many of you are singers here? How many of you are into music? Wow. Okay. My next question is, how many of you are good singers? And how many of you are very good singers? And how many of you are told to keep quiet when you sing? These are the honest people here. Okay. So I'm here to talk about leadership, but I don't think I'm big enough or of that stature to talk about, you know, how to lead a life or talk about leadership. But I can just share my experiences with you, and I can share my life story with you, and if that inspires you even 1%, I'll be more than happy. My father is here, sitting in the front row, and it's because of him that today I'm here talking to all of you and invited for a leadership event. So it's actually his hard work. My mom, my dad, my family, they all noticed my talent. And one day I was singing in my room. I was humming something, and my dad, he heard me humming that song, and he said, my nickname is Nikki. He said, "Nikki, come here. Was that you singing that song?" I said, "Hanji, I was singing it." So he told me to sing it again, and I was in tune. And he used to play guitar, and he used to sing when he was in school, so he could make out that I'm in sur and I have taal. So he asked me if I want to learn music. So that's the first thing he asked, because if you want to become excellent in a particular area, you need to learn that first. You need to be trained to stand out. So I said, yes, I want to learn. And then I started learning Indian classical music. And I also started learning Western classical music in school. And yes, school is one of the biggest influences in one's life. My teachers, they discovered my talent. And then I was called on to sing on the annual day or the Independence Day or any function in school. I used to be on the stage of the auditorium and singing all those songs. So that was a great learning experience, and singing on stage in school, in college, it gave me a lot of confidence. And since then I decided, yes, I want to become a playback singer. So it was I was 5 years old when I started singing, and by the age of say 7, 8, I decided I want to sing for movies, because I love watching movies and I wanted to hear my voice on that big screen on the beautiful actresses. And it's another high when you listen to your own voice, you know, with biggies, with big stars, and it's basically for the love of music. So yes, parents play a very important role. So if you love music and you want to do something, you should go to your parents and tell them that I really love music and I want to do this, I want to join classes, I want to learn it properly. So they'll be the one to guide you properly. And second point would be, you should know yourself. sometimes we get carried away by a lot of compliments. Oh, you sing so well, you look so nice. But you should be your best judge. So you should know where you stand, and you should be able to tell that today I didn't sing well, today I didn't dance well, I could have improved. Even in studies, you should know how intelligent you are or how you can make yourself better or make yourself get better marks. So you should be your best judge, right? That's a very, yes. You don't like this point? It's always great to get compliments, but you should be your biggest critic. Okay, never stop learning. Learning can be in the form of formal training and going to a guru and learning from your teachers in school, but you should also listen to a lot of music. I'm talking specifically about music because I'm a singer. You can listen to your idols, people you look up to, and that is also a great form of learning. When you listen to somebody and you listen to what they're saying and then you apply it in your own life, so that is very important. I hope I'm not boring you guys. Bored to nahi ho rahe aap? Is that a yes for getting bored? Where is Mr. No Name? Are you getting bored? Yes. Nowadays, okay, how many of you are addicted to iPads and iPhones? All liars. Can't be so less. What about the singing girls? Are you not addicted to iPads? No? Not your parents' iPads and iPhones? Not at all? Okay. Calm down. Even I am addicted to my phone. I was making videos of the girls who were singing so beautifully. So yes, I asked this question because these gadgets are taking a lot of our time from our lives and we forget doing important things because we're always hooked on to Facebook and Twitter. It is important to go on with the time and, you know, be updated to everything. But at the same time, it's more important to prioritize your things. I know you're too small to make priorities, but I'm sure you also have your own priorities. You need to make a list of things that should be given the most attention, and you should concentrate on doing that. Like, your homework should be a priority. Do you get homework in Singapore? Kya fayda hua? Not much, right? No homework? Lots. So the girls are saying you get lots of homework, boys are saying not much. Whom should I believe? Main kiski baat manu, boys ki ki girls ki? I heard boys. So do you give your homework to the girls? That's why they have a lot of homework to do. So yes, you should make your priorities, concentrate on your studies, and if you like doing something like singing, dancing, should go for classes. And in the end, if you get a little time, you can spend it on the gadgets. Spend more time with your family, with your parents, and learn from them. Go for outdoor activities. Travel a lot. Why am I saying this? Because you actually learn a lot when you travel, when you go to new places, when you meet new people. You never know what's in store for you, and you learn so many things. And you will realize this later when you grow up, that when you travel and you meet different kinds of people, you learn from their cultures, and you learn good habits, you learn what are bad habits, so you should not do that. So you learn so much when you go out of your house and, you know, travel and see the world. So make sure you do that and explore new places. Okay, am I talking too much?
No.
So basically it all comes down to do what you love, and you should be happy doing it. At any point of time, if you feel I'm not happy doing it, just stop and look for that thing that makes you happy. I am happy to finish this lecture now. And let's move on to the next section of the event. And Again, I would like to thank you all for such a warm welcome. And thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for the inspiring speech. I request you to take your seat on stage and meet the student panelists, Rishi, Srinandini, Arya, and Aman, who will be engaging you in an informative question and answer session. To get to know more about the great personality, over to Aman.
Thank you, Shalini. Good morning, ma'am. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our campus here. On behalf of the panelists, I would also like to mention what a privilege it is to be a part of this conversation with you here today.
Thank you.
To start off the session, we have the first question from a student at the GIIS Ahmedabad campus. Ma'am, we know that you attended the Delhi School of Music at the age of 12. Were you able to cope up with academics and music at such a young age?
For me, academics was a priority because my parents always thought that that studies are very important. And music, I was learning side by side. So my studies were never interrupted or disturbed. And even if I had to travel somewhere for a performance or something, I used to carry my books with me and I used to study while I was traveling. And I was very good at academics. I'm not lying.
Ma'am, being a music lover from your youth, who did you aspire to be like as a singer?
Well, the first name that comes to my mind is Jagjit Singh. He was a legend. I consider him a legend. I've grown up listening to his music, his ghazals, and I've learned so much just by listening to his music. The way he used to sing or approach a sentence or a line, the way he used to pronounce the words and his voice and the kind of music, how he touched millions of hearts, and especially his live concerts. I was a kid when I saw him perform live, and that day I decided that I want to do concerts like Jagjit Singh Ji. I want to become like him.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm sure our students are inspired by your motivation.
Our next question comes from the GIIS Tokyo campus. Ma'am, you've previously sung the song Balle Balle for the Pakistani film Bin Roye, and the students would like you to share your experience.
Well, Balle Balle is a song from a film called Bin Roye, as you said, and because I couldn't go to Pakistan to record the song, Shiraz Uppal has given the music of the song. So we recorded it over Skype. See, we use technology in a great way. So he logged on to Skype and I was there in the studio with my headphones on. I had the track with me. He emailed me the track. So I was listening to the music and then he was on Skype directing me to how to sing the song and how he wanted the song to be. So then we recorded the song, we emailed him back and he really liked it. And then later it was shot on the beautiful Mahira Khan. So I didn't actually meet him to record the song.
Yes, ma'am. That's very interesting. If you don't mind, could you sing a few lines from the song for us?
Oh, I don't mind.
रात की रंगीनी देखो क्या रंग लाई है हाथों की मेहंदी भी देखो खिलखिलाई है बल्ले 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 जजे है ये बावरा जिया बल्ले बल्ले नाचे है ये बावरा पिया
Obliging to sing, ma'am. That was truly mesmerizing. I would like to add that Balle Balle is one of my favorite songs.
Thank you so much.
Ma'am, our next question comes from the GIIS Abu Dhabi campus. You wear so many different turbans for your performances. We would like to know who designs them and the brooches for you.
I would like to ask who designed these turbans today.
Music teacher.
Kya baat hai, taaliyan ho jaye, ma'am ke liye. Well, it's actually a very long cloth. Malmal ka kapda hai. It's around 4-4.5 meters. The same that my dad wears. So it's nothing permanent. He has to tie it every time I perform. So yes, he's the one who ties the turban on my head.
Ma'am, we've seen you wearing a turban at public events and at performances. Ma'am, you also mentioned in one of your earlier interviews that the turban has become part of your identity. Is there any particular significance to it?
Well, it started off because of a reality show that I did. It was called Junoon Kuch Kar Dikhane Ka. It happened in 2008. And it was a competition amongst three different genres, which was Bollywood, Sufi and folk. And I was in the Sufi team. And because I was singing Sufi songs every week, I wanted my head to be covered. So one option was to take a dupatta or a chunni. And then one day in our house, we were just having a discussion and we thought, why not try something else? So my sister's husband, he suggested, why don't you try a turban? And I was like, girls don't wear turbans. So he said, no, why not try it? So my dad offered, you can take my turban. So we just tried it out and I twisted it a little according to my face structure and it looked really nice on me. So on the day of the shooting, I wore a beautiful Sufi dress and I wore the white turban with it. And it looked really royal and really, really graceful. So it started off like that, with that reason that I wanted my head to be covered. But it slowly became a style statement. And now people identify me with the turban.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am. Next, we have a question from a student from GIIS Kuala Lumpur. Ma'am, you have already sung for most of the leading music directors in the industry. What do you want to see yourself as in another 20 years?
Another 20 years, I'll be 50. I don't know what I'll be doing, but hopefully I'll be happily singing songs only. And you know, once you're into music, you always want to do that. Maybe an extension of my own singing. Maybe I'll be composing more and releasing more independent songs. Maybe I open a music school. I don't know. So nothing is planned. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow. So 20 years is too much.
Ma'am, that sure sounds interesting. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, our next question is from our GIIS Bengaluru campus. You have sung so many devotional songs. Do you have any particular reason for it?
Well, devotional music is something that we learn at a very early age. So when our parents, in our growing age, they sing hymns to us, shabads or bhajans, so that you know the child is calm. And it's a bhajan or a devotional song is like your first introduction to music. So that's what happened to me. When I was really young, my mom used to sing a lot of shabads. And in school also, there's morning prayer. We begin the day with a prayer. So that's your first introduction to God or to spirituality. So that's why I was always inclined towards devotional music. And I have listened to a lot of Sufi music, which is also a form of devotional music. So that's my way of connecting to the Almighty. And I think everybody does that. People say that music is the strongest medium to connect to God. We're too young to talk about God, but eventually, how when you're studying for your exams, you're praying to God, Bhagwan mujhe achhe number de dena. You do that, right? So we remember Him only when we want something. We should actually remember Him all the time. And the best way to do is through music.
Ma'am, do you work?
Clap for God.
You have worked in a Bollywood film, Rangde Basanti, where you sang Ik Onkar. What was it like singing a devotional song in a Bollywood film?
It was a great experience for me to sing something that I had been singing since childhood. Ik Onkar is from the Japji Sahib, and the part that I've sung for Rangde Basanti is the Mool Mantra. So that one small paragraph contains the entire meaning of being one to the God. Ek Onkar means His name is true, the true name. And to sing that for a legend like A.R. Rahman was a dream come true. I had always imagined just meeting him and just taking an autograph or just saying hello or taking a picture with him. But I never could have imagined in my dreams that I would get an opportunity to sing for him. So they narrated me the story of the movie, and they said it'll be shot at the Golden Temple. At that time, I didn't know that it was going to be in the music album also as an individual song. So when I went to buy the CD, I saw the CD and I read my name on it. Track number one, Ekonkar Harshdeep Kaur. So that feeling, just to read your name on a music album of a huge movie, music by a great music director, and something that you have been singing since childhood, it was a great feeling. And recording that for Reha Rahman was another feeling. And he was very kind to have made me feel very comfortable. He said, just close your eyes and just sing it 2-3 times. So he took the best take that I had given. So that's one of the most memorable moments in my life.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, having such an early start to your career and being an acclaimed artist at such a young age, we're curious to know, how did your interest in Sufi music develop?
Well, if you listen to my voice, it's not a typical female playback singer's voice. How Lata ji used to sing or Asha Bhosle ji used to sing. They had very high-pitched voice. But when I sing, my voice is quite low-pitched. I'm telling you the honest reason why I was inclined towards Sufi music. So I used to sing songs that suited my voice. Like I used to listen to Reshma ji, Jagjit Singh ji, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab, because I could sing along with them while the CD or the track was playing. So that was one reason that I got inclined towards the music of Reshma ji, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab. And Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab sings a lot of qawwalis and devotional music and Sufi music. So that's how I got inclined towards it. And later, when I started understanding the meaning of those words, I loved them even more. So that's the main reason.
Thank you, ma'am. That's a wonderful story. Our next question comes from our sister campus here in Singapore, GIIS Queenstown. Back in 2008, you were declared Sufi Ki Sultana by none other than Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. You were young at the time, so how did you feel when you received this title, ma'am?
I just wanted to hear my name in Amitabh Bachchan's voice. Harshdeep Kaur, Sufi Ki Sultana. So I think that was, God answered my prayers, and yes, Amitabh Bachchan ji was the chief guest on the show and he announced my name. I was very happy. That's it.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, our next question comes from our home campus, GIIS East Coast. In our school, GIIS EC, we organize the Global Indian Stars Singing Competition every year. In this competition, not only do students of GIIS campuses take part, but also all those living in Singapore who take an interest in singing. As a young singer and achiever, what is your advice to students who want to take up film singing as a career?
I think I spoke a lot over there. But if you want to take up music as a career, especially Bollywood, as you said, Bollywood film music as a career, you should shift to Mumbai. Yes, that's true. I'm from Delhi. I'm born and brought up in Delhi. But after I finished my school, we shifted to Mumbai because Mumbai is the hub for Bollywood music and movies. So everything takes place in Mumbai. All the music directors are there in Mumbai. So you should go and meet them. But if you can't, thanks to technology, you can always record your song on YouTube or anywhere and just email it to the music directors, or just open your own YouTube channel and start singing and you might get noticed. There have been success stories like these that you become popular on your social media, on your YouTube channel. If you're really good, your songs can get viral and then Bollywood will come to you, to Singapore.
That's wonderful, man. I'm sure in a few years, a lot of our students will be buying plane tickets to Mumbai. We also want to know, ma'am, is it easy getting a break in the Bollywood music industry? Do you have any tips for our students to get them on the path to success in this field?
Well, nothing is easy in life. Actually, there are certain things that are easy, but when it comes to getting a break in Bollywood, I don't think it's very easy. it looks easy ki acha ek gana aaya and singer hit ho gaya to bahut hi famous ho gaya hai ek gaane ki der thi but wo ek gaane tak wo kaise pahuncha how did that singer reach till that one song that entire journey wo koi nahi dekhta so that is very important my first song in a movie came when I was 14 or 15 years old but how did I reach that position or reach that state when I got to sing for a film was a long journey I started when I was 5 years old I kept learning and it's always you know joining dots and how you meet different people and how you make an opportunity work for you how you excel at that particular opportunity it all depends on that so it's not easy but yes your hard work pays a lot if you're really good I don't think anybody could say no to you and thoda bahut luck also matters but it's mostly hard work and talent
thank you ma'am I'm sure all of our students are motivated by your hard work
ma'am you've previously been mentored by Ustad Fateh Ali Khan a student from GIIS Pune would like to know how it was being taught by a legend like him
Rahat Fateh Ali Khan saab is a legend and he was my mentor in the reality show I did called Junoon and I thought he's such a great singer and such a big legend so I don't know how he would be in person but the day I met him on the sets of Junoon he was such a humble guy and such a humble person and very polite when he spoke not when you hear him he sings like a great singer but when he talks he's so polite and he's so soft spoken so I couldn't believe that Rahat Fateh Ali Khan is here sitting right next to me so yes I learned a lot of humility from that man and he used to give tips that you know just close your eyes just sing from your heart and he used to ask me what are you singing today and then used to guide me with about the song so it was a great experience meeting Rahat Fateh Ali Khan sir
thank you ma'am our last question for this session is from a student at the GIIS Balestier campus here in Singapore you have recorded your first album Romantica at the age of just 14 you've also recorded your first song as a playback singer at the age of 14 as well please tell us more about your first break and what it takes to achieve your dreams
well it takes a lot to achieve your dreams and it's not just one person it's a lot of people behind that person in my case it has always been my family and now my husband and his family everybody is supporting me so if I was alone and I wanted to shift to Bombay and my parents were not you know encouraging me then maybe I wouldn't have been able to go to Mumbai and become a singer so it's always your parents your teachers who push you to do better my first album came in 2001 it released in 2003 I won a reality show called MTV Gaga. Video Gaga contest so it was not just singing they wanted to check if I dance also well and I'm singing and I'm impromptu so as a prize I got an album album deal with HMV and the album was called Romantica so that was my first album and soon after that album released I got a call for a movie song for an audition they wanted to try my voice first so I went in for the audition and I was really small and they were really impressed by my voice and they said will you be able to pull off this song I said okay I'll try so they switched off all the lights so that I'm not conscious that people are watching me in the studio but I was very confident and you know when you're young you're not worried about what people will think about you and how you're looking and how you sound what happens if this doesn't go through you don't worry so much because you're a kid so you should always maintain that even if you grow so at that time I was like fearless I said I think I'll just do my best and that's what I did and the song got selected so that was my first song called Sajna Main Hari for a film called Aapko Pehle Bhi Kahin Dekha Hai so yes that was my first break and I was in Delhi only when I sang that song. But we were not in a hurry. We said, okay, let's finish my 12th. Then I'll go to Mumbai. Then I'll do my college. And then I'll start with the music. So the studies were always a priority. So yes, it's not just one person. It's a whole team behind an artist. And today I'm here because of my family, my teachers, my friends who have always encouraged me to do better.
Ma'am, I think what you said is really true. Support is essential. The people around you, they really need to be supportive. And also, I'm sure that the audience would like to know, when can we expect a new album from you?
Well, nowadays the times have changed. Earlier, we used to cut albums. An album used to have 8 songs or 6 songs or 10 songs. But now the times have changed and this is the phase of singles. And tomorrow I'm releasing a single. It's a spiritual single. It's called Satnam Vahe Guruji. Tomorrow also happens to be the Gurpurab of Guru Nanak Devji. So I'm releasing it on that occasion. It's a beautiful chant that sometimes when you're alone and you want to meditate. So this is what I sing when I just want to clear my mind and think about the Almighty and be grateful to Him for everything I have. So this is a beautiful musical chant of Satnam Vahe Guruji, which is releasing tomorrow. And I plan to release a lot of singles in the coming months, the coming years, on my own YouTube channel. Please subscribe.
Ma'am, we are all looking eagerly forward to your next song and hope to see another hit. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. How many of you are coming to the concert tomorrow? Tonight. That's why you didn't raise your hands. Otherwise, everybody's coming, right? Okay. Kis kis ki mummy papa aa rahe hain? Okay. We have a few people. That's awesome. Any more questions?
Yes. Ma'am, I'm sure we can expect a large audience for your show tonight.
I think it's almost sold out, right, Shweta? So thank you, Singapore, for all your love that the concert is going sold out, and we need your wishes for a great concert.
Yes, ma'am, thank you for coming. We thank you for your inspirational responses. I'm sure all of our students here and those watching online have found your advice useful, especially those wishing to follow in your footsteps career-wise. To conclude our session, some of our students in the audience have been eagerly waiting to ask you their questions. I request you to please proceed to the podium to address them.
Ma'am, my name is Jaydev and I'm from GIIS Ballastia. Are you an avid cat lover? Is it true and why?
I am a dog lover. Not that I hate cats, but I love dogs more. And nobody knows, but I was once bitten by a cat. Can you imagine that? And I had to take 7 injections for that. So I love dogs.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
My name is Pranav Goyal, and I'm from Queenstown campus. Kachra Hatao, Rasta Banao was a remarkable initiative taken by the people of Andheri at the Infinity Mall. You also tweeted that great steps taken by residents, where it was a really great achievement by the residents. So do you have any further comments on this?
Actually, it's always good to use your position for something nice to happen. So when you're in a position when, you know, your tweet or your opinion matters, you should make the most of it. So I feel as a musician or as a celebrity, it's your responsibility to talk about the general things happening in life or about your society. You should always promote it. So this was something happening around my area and I felt it needed to reach more people, so I tweeted about it. And also once you become famous and popular, people want to listen to you and they want to hear what you're trying to say. So you should always promote good things.
Thank
that
you,
was one of them.
Thank you.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Srishti. I'm a really big fan of yours. I love your songs. I just love your voice also.
Thank you.
So my question for you is, you have sung so many songs so far. Which one was your personal favorite where you had a really enjoyable experience?
There's so many songs that are my favorite.
Two or three? Any?
I can't choose one. You want me to choose one or tell fine?
Any two or three would be
two
good.
Or three.
Yeah.
I enjoyed singing Katya Karu because that was not an easy song, but it had a lot of drama, a lot of singing and a lot of acting in the song also. So I really enjoyed that song, recording for A.R. Rahman sir. And then there was Kabira. You know who recorded me for Kabira? Any guesses? It's Pritam Das music, Pritam Chakraborty, but Arijit Singh was recording me on the mic, and it's a duet with him, so I had a great time recording that song. And recently I loved singing Zalima again for Pritam Da.
Yes ma'am, we also love those songs. And actually my friends and I, we have prepared something for you. It's just a message to you in which your song names are embedded into the quotes which we are telling you.
Oh wow.
Yeah, so it's just a message.
How is that message? You're going to...
No, it's written here.
Okay.
Or if you like, I could even read it out for you.
You want me to read it out?
Yes.
Uff, madam ji, aapke gaane mein hamare dil mein diya jala diya. You have to count how many songs, okay? I'll ask ki kitne gaane the mere. Uff, madam ji, aapke gaane ne hamare dil mein diya jala diya. आपके गाने की सुर ने हमारे आंखों की हीर उड़ा दी. आई डोंट नो इफ इट मेक्स सेंस बट आपके गाने सुनकर हमारे मन ने कहा चल नच देने सारे और सबने कर दी कमरिया ट्विस्ट. आई कैन हियर यू काउंटिंग, नो चीटिंग. कैसी हमारी खुदगर्जी कि हम आपके गानों के दीवाने हो गए. Your die-hard fans, Roshni Sen, Srishti Ramakrishnan, and Purujit Bhai. Thank you. So how many songs? Correct answer. Thank you. Thank you so much. We have more questions? Come.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hi.
My name is Shruti, and I'm from the Queenstown campus. My question to you today is, what was your most challenging song you have ever sung in your singing industry?
Most challenging song? Wow, I don't... do you remember any? First one, because it was the longest. It was 8 minutes 14 seconds long. And I was only like 15 and I didn't know the meaning of the song. It was a song about heartbreak and the boy was leaving the girl on the day of a wedding. So just to imagine all those things was very difficult for me, but I sang anyways. So that was kind of challenging for me.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. More questions? I think I've answered a lot of questions, but you can connect to me on Facebook and Twitter. I'll be happy to answer your questions there. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, for having patiently answered all the questions. It was indeed a pleasure. Request you to take your seat as we set up the stage for the masterclass. We will now begin with the second segment of our program today, the masterclass.
This is a very great learning opportunity for each and every one of you seated here. Please utilize this to the fullest, which means be calm, be patient, and listen and learn from the entire class. Do you all understand? Yes. So are you looking forward to it? Very nice. Thank you.
We will now begin with the masterclass session where Ms. Harshdeep Kaur will be speaking to us about classical Sufi music along with a demonstration of the same. May I request Ms. Karishma Khanna from Teamer Productions to introduce to us the musicians.
Good morning, everyone. It is such a pleasure for us to be here today and meeting so many young and talented students of GIIS. Thank you so much for today. Before we start the next session, I would like to introduce the two musicians who are also experts in their field. And they're joining Harshdeep. I'm happy to introduce Amit Dutt and Sanjoy Dar. Amit Dutt started learning the tabla at the age of 7 years. He has been a student of Ustad Allah Rakha Khan and Ustad Zakir Hussain. He is known for combining traditional sounds with modern percussion techniques and has accompanied eminent artists like B.L. Subramaniam, Viku Vinayak, Ustad Rashid Khan, Udit Narayan, Shankar Mahadevan. I think the list is quite long to cover right now. Then we have Sanjoy Das on the guitar. Sanjoy likes to be known as a new age guitar player in today's Indian music industry. He has done recordings as a soloist and has also performed all over the world, again with top artists such as Hariharan, Pankaj Udas, late Sri Jagjit Singh, Pandit Vishwa Mohan Bhatt, and music directors like Vishal Shekhar, Preetam, Sanjay Leela Bhansali, and many, many others. He has also recorded for MTV Coke Studios India. This is a very small snippet of their long list of accomplishments. Let's give them a big round of applause. Start with the natural question, which I think we all would like to know, especially today where we are addressing the future of our nation. We'd love to hear from both of you how you started your journey in music at such a young age and what was your inspiration. Amit.
Hi everybody, and thank you so much for lovely, beautiful, warm welcome. We are really touched. And I started, I'm a tabla player. This is tabla, you must, everybody knows. This is our Indian traditional instrument. And I started when I was very young. And as the Harshdeep ji said, you know, the parents make always important role in our life. So same like my mother, you know, who inspired us, me for doing tabla. She used to play dholak and she used to sing something. So she inspired me to play tabla. And then I start learning my tabla from my guru, first guru Pandit K.L. Bhatt. Then later on I went to Bombay for Ustad Allah Rakha Khan Sahib and my Ustad, Ustad Zakir Hussain ji. And how many of you know about the tabla? Can you raise your high hands? Please, thank you. Very little. Okay. Okay, so I just want to tell you about tabla. This is very old Indian instrument. And it used for all the basic and advanced music activity in all over the world for Indian, and even nowadays we are listening tabla with the Western instruments with drums and all. So tabla mein kuch uske bol hote hain basically jo hum bajate hain. How we talk each other, hi, how are you, what's your name, you know. So aise tabla mein bhi bol hote hain, ta takita dha tarikata gadikita dha katakatarikita dha. So there's a language of tabla also, which we learn from the basics. How we learn in vocal music, sa re ga ma. So it's same in tabla also, we learn the basic bol, ta, ti, ki, ta, then ge ge. Yeah, then becomes two bols all together, dha. Tirikita, tuna, katta. So you can make out when I'm saying the word, and you can, you know, recognize the sound which I'm playing from tabla. So katta, kirda kitari kirda, tina kina dha, dha dha ti dha. So we learned all the sounds how to take out from the tabla, and now I'm playing little of the very very common sound. You must have heard, you know, the horse stepping sound. You know how the horse runs, So, recognize the horse stepping. Very fast, very far. Coming back. So these are the very, this is like invention of our Ustad Zakir Husseinji, who, you know, we learned how to from our regular sounds we take out from the tabla, and other sounds come out from the scooter, how the scooter start. Can I have one, is there more volume of this? Somebody pushing the kick, it's not starting. One more very interesting sound, we all from India. So in India, the train is going on. Train, hum train mein jaate hain, ek dusre. How many of you regular go to India, visit India? Everybody. So everybody is aware about the Indian train. So I just tell you about the Indian train sound. Yeah? So apan sab aaj bhi India ki sair karte hain chalke. So ab train India se station se chhoot rahi hai. Garden city thi. There are many advantages to learning music. It increases your concentration. Since we rehearse, we practice one particular bowl or one same exercise regularly, 100 times, 200 times, 1000 times, 5000 times, 10,000 times. We rehearse same exercise many times. So it increases our concentration level to how to perfect in our exercise, in our regular bowls. And it gives you always, you know, the adding value whenever you, when you complete your education, college. So whenever you get opportunity to in some other place where the many people are there, you can make your point through your music. You can get the opportunity to sing you can get opportunity to play tabla, you can get opportunity to play guitar. And the place where many people who don't know about you, yourself, you can make your point through the music, you can start singing some song in front of 1,000 people and you can make, oh, this is a guy. Whenever we go, like many of you will become engineer, doctors, artists and other fields. So you will go in other place. I also, when I was in school, I was studying there. And when I left my school, I went to my college. So in college, there's a many new, you know, my the new friends circle becomes many. I met the many new friends, new boys and the new girls. So when the, you know, time comes, teacher call, acha, we are doing for some social events, some. So how many of you can take a participate? So I was playing tabla, so I told my teacher, my sir, I'm a tabla, I play tabla, and from school I'm playing. So my college activity, I can give my tabla participation, you know. So I performed in my college activity. So suddenly I came in limelight. There was a 5,000 new students there. Everybody came from the different background in college. And when I played tabla in my college, I suddenly came in limelight. And all the teachers, all the professors, everybody noticed my talent. And they start, you know, giving me their, like, oh, he's a good artist. Even he is a good talented guy who can study and who can. So whenever go your company or other place where you perform some little bit music, it gives you adding value. Everybody is 100% there, but if you are a musician or you sing or you play guitar, you play tabla, it's adding your 10 points there, so you will be a 110 there. So you must do whatever activity you want to do, either music, vocal, singing, playing guitar. So this is the advantage of music, and I'm feeling very, you know, blessed to got opportunity to working with so many legends and still learning. I'm sharing my experience. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Amit. So music really helps you to connect with people and the outside world. Sanjoy, over to you.
First, I want to say big thanks to GIIS. The same line, the warm welcome. Yes. I never seen before like this. It's true. And I'm so happy today. I'm holding most popular instrument in the world. The guitar, and I started learning when I was in class 5th standard, you know, I was so young. So aisa tha, mera parents ne socha beta bahar nahi jayega, ghar pe baith ke kuch to sikhega, so like that. And today, with blessings of God and blessings of my seniors, I'm here. And I have started my Bollywood journey from 2008. Before that, I was in Kolkata. That's my hometown. I started work for films and albums. This instrument is very unique because it's a harmony instrument, like. You can deliver your emotion by one chord. On some phrase. And I want to say one thing, as an Indian musician, whatever you want to do, like dance, singing, guitar playing, piano playing, violin playing, please learn tabla first, because you should know our Indian rhythm. If rhythm in your life, and you can learn melody instrument, harmony instrument, you can apply the rhythm and harmony together. It's very necessary. Or you can learn talam, Indian talam, like ta, takete dha, ti, ta, ta, takete dha, ti, ta, lot of things there. Amit can explain better than me because he's a rhythm player. So I have started Bollywood journey with a very popular song. I played a lot of movies, but one song still now is like a landmark of Bollywood called Ik Tara. composed by my brother Amit Trivedi. And still now, I played a lot of Punjabi stuff, but my most favorite song is Ikkuri. Yeah.
Sanjay, you have to play them for us. A few lines.
So, okay, I'm playing Iktara. Punjabi song. As a musician, and it's my it's a blessings from God. I have worked with so many legends, and I'm working with so many legends, and every day I'm learning from them. I want to say one senior's name. He's a very, very big musician of our nation, Sir Uttam Singh. He is an eminent violin player, an arranger, and a composer. And it was a fantastic experience from my side. When he called me in the studio, "Hello, Sanjay, I am Uttam Singh. I'm sir. It's my privilege to work with you." And he gave me one paper, which is not common today in our studios. So a lot of composers, they called us, they say, "Do something, this track, this is a film. Can you do something?" They don't have, most of them, they don't have their mind what I should play. They can't say, "You have to play this note, this note, this note." But that guy gave me one notation paper with everything, what I should play, what inversion I should play. So it was a fantastic experience, and it's always fantastic experience to work with legend musician, educated musicians. And you have to ready with your education to face that moment. You have to be ready. So learning process for whole life. So we can start something like konakol. Konakol means we can talk each other. "Hi, takate da."
"I'm fine. Takate pe takate da."
Fantastic. "How was your breakfast?" "Da ti da kate da takate da ti da."
"I ate so much. I kate da takate dum takate pe takate da."
"Tatti takate da ti takate da ti takate." Like same like me. Now we are coming with the melody and the rhythm. Other, You don't need any words. You can talk with the Bolvani and some melody, some notes. So I want to ask Harshdeep. And I know her from 2008 when we have started the Coke Studio Season 1 in India. So please welcome to on stage. She is not only a good musician and not only talented, she is an educated musician. ये दोनों में बहुत फर्क है. अच्छा गाना गाते हैं और सीखे गाना गाते हैं. टैलेंट भगवान देता है, ऊपर वाला ने देता है. बट यू शुड लर्न व्हाट यू आर प्लेइंग एंड व्हाट यू आर सिंगिंग. इफ यू नो दैट, इट्स वेरी क्लियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. एंड शी इज एन एजुकेटेड म्यूजिशियन एंड we are so happy we share music, we share stage with educated musician.
Thank you, Dada.
Yes, we can learn from you also.
When we have amazing musicians like Amit ji and Sanjoy Das ji, I think the singer doesn't have to do anything much. Taliyan bajate, sorry. We were called here. These are the masters. I am not the master at all.
No. We are students.
I am still learning.
We are
not because I am young. younger. But I feel I'm still a student learning.
Yes.
But I'm asked to give you a master class. It's a huge name, master class. But
one
I can share what I can.
One thing I want to share. She said one name. सर जगजीत सिंह. मैं उनको सर बोलता हूँ बिकॉज आई बिलीव ही वॉज सरकार ऑफ इंडियन म्यूजिक एंड स्टिल नाउ ही इज द सरकार ऑफ इंडियन म्यूजिक. एक आई प्लेड विथ हिम फॉर लास्ट थ्री ईयर्स 1911 आई वॉज विथ हिम. मैं उनके एक रिकॉर्डिंग पे गया था. उन्होंने बुलाया था मेरे को फर्स्ट. तो उन्होंने कॉर्ड लिख के दिया था मेरे को, बजाओ. उनका ऐसे ही एटीट्यूड था. गिटार बजाते हो? हाँ हाँ जी. बजाओ ये. मैंने देखा, मैं ओके. तो मैंने रिकॉर्ड किया वो, तो कुछ नहीं बोल रहे हम सर, इट्स ओके. बजाओ, आके सुनो क्या बजाया. तो कंसोल में जाके मैं सुना, तो मैं बोला हाँ इज इट ओके, सही लग रहा है क्या. मेरे को पूछ रहे हैं आपने जो कॉर्ड्स लिख के दिया उसके ऊपर ही मैं बजाया. तो उन्होंने एक चीज़ बोला मेरे को, घर पे चलते हो ना भागते हो. हाँ चलता हूँ. म्यूजिक इट्स लाइक होम, चलना सीखो भागो मत.
Wow.
So still now, it's always in my mind. और एक चीज मेरे को बोला था, when you go to studio for any recording, for any film recording, for any album recording, try to understand the poetry first. Because poetry can say the philosophy of the song. So, and decide what you should not play on the track. Then it will come what you should play.
So that is applied in general life also, not just music.
Yes.
You should be very clear in your mind of what you want in your life. So all these students jo mere samne, are you all into music?
Yes.
All of you?
Yes.
So these tips that Sanjay ji and Amit ji have given you will always be in your mind.
Yeah.
Always remember them. They're going to be very helpful. And when it comes to singing, I think learning is very important. You need to find your teacher, your guru, jinke saath aap comfortable ho, jo aapko pyar se sikhaye. Aur practice is very important because like instrument, your voice is your instrument. So you have to work on it every day. Even if it is for some time. Jesse, in older times, they used to say, you know, we used to practice for 10 hours, 12 hours. I know with studies and everything.
Yeah.
Today, it's not possible.
It's not possible.
Yes.
But you should take out some time for music and sing with your favorite song or just sit down. And nowadays, there are so many apps. I have an app on my iPhone called the iTabla Pro. And it has a Tanpura. So I just, you know, switch it on and I sing with it, and I try to match my voice with it, and I try to improve my notes. So will you sing with me now? Let's do a small session. So always begin with silence, always, because you need to hear yourself. So always begin with Om, because it said that the beginning of any sound in the world comes from Om. So always take a deep breath. Breathing is very important in singing. So let's do it together. I'll say it once and then you sing it with me. Are we ready?
Yes.
Take a deep breath.
Oh God.
So funny.
Yeah, aapka BP check ho raha hai. Hum with me. जहाँ तक आपकी ब्रेथ जा रही है हम टिल देयर एंड इफ यू फील यू आउट योर ब्रेथलेस जस्ट स्टॉप देयर एंड बिगिन अगेन रेडी नाउ योर टर्न 1 2 3 Are you feeling? It's so peaceful.
Yeah.
Once again. Beautiful. Now let's do Om. Om. One more time. See, now you're in peace with yourself, you can hear yourself, and you should listen to your voice and see where you can improve. Your voice might shiver when you start doing the practice, but if you continue doing it for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it's going to improve and you'll hear the improvement right there. And next, then you can move on to say Sa. So everybody, on the same note, sing Sa with me. Ready? Ready? In Sur. Sa. And then we practice the vowels, how in English there is A, E, I, O and U. So instead of U, we'll sing U. So we start with A. A. For yourselves, come on. So when you do this in your practice, you might think, oh, this is very boring, you know, when you keep humming and doing Om and doing all these vowels, but these are actually the base of your singing. So if your Sa is in place, you'll be able to sing the other notes properly. So always your bass should be very strong. So now let's do Saregama. Everybody knows Saregama, right? Pakka na, Doremi to nahi karna. It doesn't matter, language doesn't matter, because music is beyond any language. But today we'll do Saregama.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Syllable word, fusion music. It's very syllable. What is this? You all and Harshdeep singing Saregama.
It's
completely
together.
Indian. Yeah? And I am playing chords, which is completely Western theory. We can say this is a platform of fusion music. Nothing is special. This is.
So do what your heart says.
Yes.
Also, when Bapida spoke about Jagjit Singh, so Jagjit Singh ji gave me a lot of tips for singing.
Yeah.
I have a very heavy voice, and certain people, kids think that, oh, I can't sing that high. So he told me that every person is born with a different vocal cord, right? All our voices are different, or sabki apni apni voice ki alag pehchan hai. तो सबकी आवाज़ की फ्रीक्वेंसी भी डिफरेंट है सबके वोकल कॉर्ड्स भी डिफरेंट हैं सो लाइक हाउ श्रेया घोषाल डजंट साउंड लाइक सुनिधि चौहान हर वॉइस इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम हर राइट सो एवरीबडी हैज़ अ यूनिक वॉइस यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज़ योर हाइएस्ट पिच वॉट इज़ योर लोएस्ट पिच वॉट इज द सुर दैट यू आर कम्फर्टेबल ऑल्सो वन मोर थिंग दैट ही टॉट मी वॉज ऑलवेज सिंग इन द वॉइस यू स्पीक इन So it's not like if I talk like this, hi, aap kaise hain? And suddenly I sing like, la, 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 suddenly I start to sing loudly. So you should always try to sing in your speaking voice because this is a gift of God, your vocal cords. You don't want to lose them by shouting. And why are there microphones? You have a microphone so that you don't have to shout, right? So always sing in the voice that you speak in. So always remember that. Don't strain your voice. And
this is the same thing with the instrument. Amit is playing this tabla.
Yes.
If any other person will sit with this tabla, na, it will sound different. And for my guitar also, the same thing.
Yes.
The touch, the weight, everything is different. It's a different person.
Also, you must learn an instrument so that you know about the chords and about sur, about tal. It will help you in your singing.
Yes.
Should we sing something?
Yes.
What would you like to hear? Heer and Kabira. Okay, everybody who's watching this online or everywhere.
So I can request to Harshdeep.
Kabira or
Heer? First, please sing Heer. Then we can go to Kabira because our basic music is our folk music and classical music. I'm saying that your traditional Heer. Yeah, film music is a part of Indian music,
yes.
But that is not basic Indian music. That is not our traditional music. Film music like a part of square feet.
Also, these songs will be performing tonight at the concert.
Yes.
So everybody watching online, there are still a few tickets left. You can come and watch the show. वॉच द कॉन्सर्ट. मुझे ये चीज़ भी जगजीत सिंह जी ने कही थी कि कभी भी कॉन्सर्ट को शो नहीं करना. मैं क्या शो कर रहा हूँ, कुछ भी नहीं शो कर रहा. इट्स अ कॉन्सर्ट.
कॉन्सर्ट
यू शुड कम एंड लिसन एंड एंजॉय. इट्स लाइक एन एक्सपीरियंस
एंड सो प्रेजेंट इट लाइक अ कॉन्सर्ट.
कॉन्सर्ट
इट्स नॉट अ डांस इवेंट.
तो हम थोड़ा सा इनको ग्लिम्प्स दे देते हैं.
यस,
हमने आज रात को क्या करना.
सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग यू हियर.
आई विल बिगिन विद अ फोक सॉन्ग Heer Ranja and then I'll move on to the film version. But there's one more thing that is the most important. Can you guess?
Emotion.
Yes, emotion.
आप उनको सारे हिंट दे जा रहे हो पपिता. But he's correct. Emotions.
Yeah.
The feelings with which you sing is very important. So if we take a song like say. जो तेरी खातिर तड़पे पहले से ही. Wait. I'm saying it without any feelings. क्या उसे तड़पाना ओ ज़ालिमा. ये लोग सब प्लेइंग विदाउट फीलिंग्स. ओ ज़ालिमा सो समटाइम्स इट्स नॉइज़ टू द इयर्स. तो इसमें क्या मिसिंग है? फील.
यस
दादा थोड़ा फील से. सी लुक एट हिज फेस हाउ ही इज प्लेइंग द गिटार. ऑल्दो ही इज नॉट प्लेइंग विद हिज फेस बट ही इज एक्चुअली यूजिंग हिज इमोशंस एंड हिज फीलिंग्स इनटू हिज प्लेइंग. इसको भी थोड़ा जोर से बजाओ. सी यू लूज द म्यूजिक सो यू नीड टू बी इन ट्यून एंड यू नो फील द सॉन्ग बिफोर यू सिंग इट. तो थोड़ा सा आपके लिए हम गा देते हैं. But I have one condition. You'll have to sing with me. Are you with me? enjoyed. So basically, if you love music, if you're singers, the main aim should be to have fun. If you're not having fun, then don't sing. Okay?
Thanks.
So have fun and enjoy what you do. God bless you all. Thank you so much again. Thank you.
I'm sure it was a great learning session for all our music lovers seated here. Dear friends, let us have another huge round of applause for our special guest. We'll be right back.